So, Pap, obviously a lot of news this week and big news coming out of Wisconsin. We'll talk more about that later in the program. But let's talk about another ground zero for at least the 2012 election is going to be Florida, as it tends to be every year. And we've seen this movie before in Florida when it comes to suppressing voters, because we know that demographically speaking, the Republicans are in trouble, particularly in a national election. But your governor, Rick Scott, he's trying to, well, I guess, even the playing field when it comes to demographics, right?
Well, what the governor's doing is making Florida into a Selma, Alabama, circa 1963. I mean, you have the federal government telling this buffoon of a governor, do not do this. You've been we're demanding that you stop the purge now. Now, this is
we've got two different, there's basically two different tracks the Republicans are following to suppress the vote, right?
Well, that's right. That's right. But let's talk about the purge. Let's talk about the purge, and then we'll talk about what Judge Hinkle did over in Tallahassee.
Okay.
First of all, in the purge, we start off with to understand who is really behind this. It's Rick Scott and a guy named Ken Detzner. Now, you have to understand, Detzner has this is exactly how he was appointed as Secretary of State. You had Kurt Browning in Florida who resigned because he basically told the governor, what you're doing is illegal, this is a scam, I'm not going to participate in it. I'm worried about being criminally prosecuted. That's exactly what Scott was told. Okay, those and Kurt Browning, let me just tell you, is no angel. Kurt Browning had ties to Catherine Harris the first time they purged all these people that should not have been purged in Florida. But let me just tell you something. Kurt Browning at least had enough class to say, look, Rick Scott, you know what you're doing is illegal. I know what you're doing is illegal, and I'm not going to do it. But then along comes this Detzner character. Now, it's amusing to understand who he is, but it's almost incredible to believe that the media is not talking about this. Detzner, his experience is it comes from he was a liquor lobbyist.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the way he gets put into office is one day he simply happens to be coming by the governor's office on a routine lobbying mission, and Scott says, "Oh, by the way, Mr. Detzner, how would you like to be Secretary of State? I swear to you, that is what happened." He stopped. He's lobbying for the liquor industry, which is what he does. I mean, he's a lobbyist for the alcohol industry. Going by the office, Scott says, "You know, would you mind being Secretary of State, and would you mind doing this for me?" Well, what he asked him to do was up front. Scott already knew that part of the GOP agenda nationally, because he'd been to the ALEC meetings, they had met with the governors. They ordered the Republican governors to do this. And so the Republican governors knew their mission. So he knows, who do I get that will ignore the law? Well, he gets Detzner. So Detzner says, sure, I'll do it. I'll purge. I'll do it. You know, Kurt Browning won't do it. By God, I'll do it.
And we should be clear on what this purge was. It was essentially Detzner using the Department of Motor Vehicle rules to attempt to determine who may or may not be an actual citizen. Took 180 some odd thousand names.
182,000, yeah.
182,000 names. And of course, you cannot divine directly from from licenses whether or not someone is a citizen.
Of course not.
They sent these. They targeted these 182,000, and of course, they were much more heavily targeted in Democratic areas amongst African Americans.
60%, Sam. 60% minorities.
And then essentially, the plan was, we're going to send out notices to people. We're gonna mark them in some type of envelope, and if they don't respond within 30 days, we're going to automatically assume, not that they haven't responded, not that we need to follow up, that they don't belong on the voter rolls. This is, I mean, just when I think of how many times I am 30 days over on my electric bill, or 30 days over on anything, that just in and of itself, that dynamic is unbelievable.
Well,
but of course, the feds had even greater problems with it.
Understand, this is not just Florida. This is Alec met with the Republican governors they knew they could order around. Okay, Rick Scott obviously is just such a nothing of a character. They knew they could order him around. So he's on this program. You've got several other states. Look to the state. If it's Republican governor and Republican legislature, this is going to happen. So what happened here? There are all kinds of ridiculous stories. I mean, you had a 91-year-old World War II veteran. He was taken off the rolls. He had to show his citizenship. One of the election officials actually tweeted a picture of himself with a man who had received the letter telling the man that we're going to arrest you for a felony if you come vote. That's what they're doing. They're using the word felony. They're scaring people away. And then the election official tweets the picture of these two guys standing side by side, and the guy who's going to be held accountable for a felony has his U.S. passport, has everything he needs to vote. And so, you know, Colorado and New Mexico, where there's high Latino populations, they've launched these efforts to purge the voting rolls, because it's what we talked about last week, Sam. They've done the numbers. All they need is 9 states to figure if they can shave 1%, 1% of that voting, if they can get 1% of those voters not to show up, they win.